It is 20 years now since the earthquake hit Gujarat on 26 January 2001. The tectonic shift that day released energy not just devastating life and property, it also unlocked and released tremendous positive human energy directed towards strengthening risk management in the country. Looking back at the experiences of post-earthquake reconstruction, I feel humbled with what the communities taught us about the meaning of people-led recovery and what they are capable of given an opportunity. It is not merely about construction technology, its norms, or skill training events that we conducted. The lesson learned is about how people's own agency is the key to effective and sustainable recovery and resilience. We were engaged in supporting housing reconstruction for a community in one of the isolated remote hamlets in the run beyond Rapper who were left out from the government supported program. The government program was to provide cash assistance to people, as you all know, but most NGOs still preferred supplying material, supporting labor costs, guiding with the design and technology through participatory processes. And many of these projects made sincere efforts to incorporate people's inputs and preferences. After supporting housing reconstruction in Kutch in many other villages, I was very confident that the only way any effective recovery could happen was if we would empower the community by placing money in their hands. So after making some calculations about the cost of construction for our own project management, we decided to sit with the community to discuss how they wanted to build their houses. We decided to provide cash assistance to them as they constructed and discuss only disaster resistant features. Other things would be on agenda of discussion or support only if they wanted. We realized they required and expected much lesser money than we had calculated for each stage. By the time we completed reconstruction work, we had saved money as people could build with much lesser than our budget. At the same time, people had also been able to save through their own collective management. Not only satisfied with their own houses, but very proud of building themselves and learning in the process, they had also bought bicycles, radios, goats, and many other such things with their savings. We learned how cost effective people can be once they own the process and the resources. We just needed to trust and strengthen their own agency. This is the lesson we took away from the experience in Kutch. This lesson proved invaluable in all other places where we have been working, most recently in Nepal. And this lesson has been reinforced with each experience. I feel it is we, NGOs, recovery and reconstruction experts, who still need to figure out and improve our engagement more. At a time when the institutions of power display their reluctance to heed to people's voices and insist on approaches that threaten to take away control from them, it becomes more critical to remind ourselves of the strength of people's own initiatives. It is important to figure out how to be on the side of the people and not allow their agency to be weakened. Personally, I feel that to be the biggest lesson from our post-earthquake recovery experience of Kutch. Working in Kutch also provided opportunity to meet many co-travelers in the journey of work in disaster management sector and form new friendships. These friendships have provided continuous intellectual nourishment and enriching an engagement together. I hope this collective journey continues with our objective of strengthening our communities towards more resilience. Thank you.